Hi there, and welcome to this lecture on process flow diagrams, equipment symbol representations. My name is Marina Miletic. Just so we become more familiar with these different pieces of equipment, I'd like to show you some examples of many of the symbol representations you'll see in a process flow diagram. You'll see these when reading process flow diagrams or piping and instrumentation diagrams on the job or when using process simulation software such as ChemCAD or Aspen. Let's look at some common equipment symbols. These are symbols of compressors and turbines or expanders. This characteristic wedge-like shape came about because of how large process-scale axial compressors look when you open up the casing. Gases and vapors are accelerated using rotating blades called rotors, and the gas is compressed by being sent through a tapered channel. In ChemCAD, compressors and turbines are colored, and in Aspen, they're this characteristic gray color. It's important to remember that compressors only compress gases and vapors. Compressors are very expensive pieces of equipment, and sending a liquid through them will damage the rotors and stators. Remember that pumps are what we use to pressurize liquids. Turbines, on the other hand, decompress gases, vapors, and liquids. Both compressors and turbines have the letter abbreviation C. This is a little counterintuitive for turbines since you expect them to be a letter T, but I find that it's useful to remember that turbines can essentially be thought of as compressors in reverse, so they have the symbol C. These symbols are fairly common on diagrams. See if you know what these are. These are all pumps, and they have the letter abbreviation P. This is the most common general symbol for a pump, and this is the representation of a pump with a spare. The job of a pump is to pressurize liquids. They should never be used to pressurize vapors, otherwise the pump will be damaged by cavitation. Remember that compressors are designed to pressurize vapor or gas. These are not physically accurate representations of pumps, and I encourage you to search for and look at pictures of actual pumps in chemical processes. But so you can understand how these units function, let's briefly look at some key parts. This symbol is usually a representation of a centrifugal pump. This circle represents the volume the fluid flows into and out of. This bottom portion is the stand the pump rests on. Fluid usually enters the center of the pump and will exit perpendicular to the inlet. On the inside, there's an impeller which rotates at hundreds or thousands of revolutions per minute. Behind the pump, there's a motor which is responsible for spinning the shaft that rotates the impeller. The fluid enters the pump in the center, and the impeller blade flings the liquid outward towards the casing. This work being done on the fluid results in an increase in pressure as the fluid leaves the pump. This pressure increase is critical for moving fluids upward or across long lengths of piping from one process unit to another. Lastly, in terms of pump symbols and simulation software, this pump symbol is what's commonly used in ChemCAD, and this is the symbol used in Aspen.